live with you. This woman had no rights. Her life was awful. There was more to it, but I think you're getting the idea that the life of a woman in this day, she had no rights. She was not looked upon with value. She was just above a dog. But Paul comes along, changes everything. He said, we don't roll like that anymore. He said, women, it's a new day. He's talking about women's lib. Paul was a leader of women's liberation. He said, I'm going to place you on a pedestal. I'm going to compare you to the bride of Christ. The most valuable thing, the thing I've written this whole book about. He said, you are a picture of that. You beautiful queen. I'm going to place you in a place where, do you have to submit to your husband? Yes, of course, because there's an order of things, just as the church submits to Christ. But that's where the blessing flows in submission. He said, but as a result, it's a whole new day. He is to love you with the love of God. He is to serve you. He is to sacrifice for you. No longer does put you in an apartment and go do whatever he thinks he's going to be able to do that, like he's single or something. Them days are over. He is going to learn to value you. He is going to learn to live his life around you. That's a whole new day. Paul wasn't against women. Paul was for women. It was a whole new day for the woman. This changed everything in the life of a woman. We are still being affected, even in secular culture, by this radical change. This radical new way of viewing a woman. This was new. That she was valued, esteemed, and prized. And that you only had one. It was new. So I want you to know that yes, it does have to do with submission. But I also want to point out to you, it says, wives be in submission, subjection, submission, same thing, unto your own husbands as unto the Lord. I love to hear my wife talk about this with other ladies because apparently I've been a great test and teacher as to how to get this. And she shares with them the revelation that the way you will succeed in submitting to your husband. And I'm not talking about an abusive, mean jerk of a husband. I'm not talking about illegal or sin. I'm talking about normal life in a relationship, in a healthy marriage. The way that you submit to that husband is when you look at him, you say, Lord, I'm not submitting only to my husband. I'm submitting to you, Jesus. I'm submitting to you, Father. It says, submit to him as unto the Lord. The secret to success in submission is bringing Jesus and placing him in front of your husband. Because your husband's like me, he's got issues. Thank you for amening me, baby. He's got issues. But if you say, Jesus, I need you now to stand in front of my husband, because I don't want to submit, but Jesus, I love my husband. And more than that, I love you. And I want to obey you because I want to bring you glory. When the heavens look at my home and they look at our marriage, when they look at me as his wife, I want them to say, only God could do that. And that brings him glory. And where there is obedience, there will be a blessing. We want to be blessed? Obedience. Submission. Don't have time to keep going, but we're going to get the guys. We'll get them next week. I want to talk about the men and the children next week. We're going to deal with some good stuff. We're talking about Jesus in the home, reflecting God's glory. So make sure, bring your husband next week. Bring your children. Bring your neighbor. Bring somebody. We're going to wrap this thing up, Ephesians chapter 6. Please read Ephesians 5 and 6 if you have it. Okay? If you will, stand up to your feet. Everybody okay? Anybody need a Band-Aid? First aid kit? Hey, don't forget the Right Now Media. I need your email address. I want you guys to check that out. You're going to be pleasantly surprised. You're going to love it. You're going to like it.
Yeah.
It's good. And Scott Adler, I'm supposed to say something. 3 o'clock. What is it? Softball, 3 o'clock for 12 and over.